President, thank you very much for having me back.
Welcome again to the most beautiful country in America.
I'm not here to argue, although this is a glorious place. Mr. President, when I was here 6 months ago, the economy was in rough shape. You told me there was no plan B. Well, I'm back.
That was the day of the famous phrase.
I'm back.
They took it in the local press.
Plan A seems to be working pretty well. You must be pleased.
Yes, I'm really pleased, and we are more enthusiastic than ever. We know that it's just the beginning, because we talked that day, my first commitment is to reduce poverty, and for that I need to keep growing and growing for many years. No? But I feel that we have already started. Things are improving, investments are growing in different sectors. So what we are achieving is solid, based in the truth, saying the truth in every sense. No? Now we have an independent central bank. We have a bureau of statistics that shows up the figures and the real figures every month or every semester, and keep telling my citizens that we have to believe in our strength, no? In our capabilities, and work together. And I think that this is working. It's working, really working. And they are backing that.
Do you feel as though the economy has enough momentum to say that it has turned the corner?
Yes. I feel that we have turned the corner. We are growing. And again, without a fixed exchange rate, without any type of price controls, we have been reducing inflation. We had cut it to half of, and next year it's going to be lower, and I'm more confident than ever that in 2019 we will have single digit inflation, and that is fundamental, because inflation affects always first to the people with lower incomes. So I need to cap poverty, and in that sense our first priority is reducing inflation.
You're almost halfway through your four-year term. Mm-hmm. How good a job do you think you've done so far?
What I'm sure is that I put everything of me. I've been working every day from early in the morning, and trying to put together a very good team of talented people, honest, committed, and I think that there is always a learning process, no? So my government now is working much better than they first, because it's obvious, no? The majority of them didn't ever even have one experience in the public sector. So that takes time, no? But fortunately now things are working. We are very consolidated as a team. That's quite unique for the history of Argentina. I really feel that there is a good environment, no? We shared all the efforts, and you know that the important transformations are always linked between more than one minister. So you need to keep working together four or five ministries at the same time if you want to achieve that reform. And Argentina needs to be in a permanent reform for many years. In addition to what we did wrong in the past, we have to face a world that is changing all the time. So you have to be open to keep changing. No?
Argentina has an important election next month.
Yes.
It is effectively a referendum on your presidency. That's how midterms tend to work for first-term presidents. If Cambiemos, your coalition, does well in the midterms, will you run for a second term in 2019?
I've been very clear since the beginning that I'm open to that. But I think it's not time to talk about that. Huh? But I'm ready to work till the end of the constitutional terms.
But why not talk about it? Because the people of Argentina, if you're right, and this country needs to be on the reform path for years, mm-hmm. beyond this four-year term, mm-hmm. wouldn't you want them to know that you'll be there for a second term to keep that reform machine running?
I want them to know that they can always count on me. is correctly say that, yes, that they can count on me. But I think that we don't have to talk about that now. It's a long time to go. For me, every day is a chance to achieve some new reform that will create new jobs. So I'm fully committed on that, and I want to be focused on that. Then we can talk by the end of next year what we are going to do in 2019. I think that is plenty of time.
But not until the end of 2018. How many seats do you think Cambiemos can win in the lower house, and how many in the upper house in this election?
I'm not counting that every day. I leave that to Marcos Peña, to Rogelio Frigerio.
Those are important numbers.
Yes, but they told me that we are going to gain places at both chambers, and so I'm quite confident that will happen. I expect that the citizens will take this chance to ratify that they had decided this change. It's not my change, it's their change. That's what is surprising the rest of the world, no? Or what is going on in Argentina. That is the decision of a population, a decision of a society that had finally understood which is the way and wants to show that we had learned of our mistakes. That is the great change of Argentina, that we are expressing a real decision that we had taken with our intelligence and with our hearts, no? And we are really committed in this. That's why the changes are improving every day.
Well, the context for these changes is, of course, the past. And the past is Kirchnerism. If your man wins the Senate race in Buenos Aires province, and polls, as you are no doubt aware, show him well ahead.
Well ahead, no. I've seen...
Ahead.
Ahead. Just ahead.
If he wins...
We are well ahead in the whole country.
If he wins, is Kirchnerism dead?
Because he's
running against Cristina, of course.
I think that Argentina will never go back to the past. That's why I'm so confident that we are moving forward, and that is a final decision of the majority of the society. So Peronismo will have to go through a huge internal reform. That's what I'm feeling. The Kirchnerismo could be going to the past, and I think that there's no chance for Argentina to go to the past again.
It sounds to me like you think it's dead already.
Well, she will be there, and she will be the senator, she will express an important part of the society, but I think that the majority had understood that we cannot grow if we continue being isolated of the world, that we cannot grow if we not renew our educational public system, and if we don't start to work and live in the truth. Fundamental values that we are expressing and we have been constantly expressed in the last 2 years.
The World Economic Forum, the organization that holds the Davos meeting that you've attended, just this week published its Global Competitiveness Report. And that report ranks 137 countries, and Argentina placed 92nd. Now, 92nd is better than Argentina did last year, but it still has to be embarrassing to be behind Greece, to be behind Brazil. Tell me, Mr. President, what are your top three legislative priorities to fix that competitiveness problem?
We are working every day, Eric, on that. We have to renew all the internal processes with the customs, with the IRS, with the other national institutions or offices that allows your exports, your production, and we are cutting that. For example, today I had announced simplified society, so you can inscribe your society in a couple of hours. Before that, in Argentina, it took like half a year. So you start your activity, right? It's unbelievable. But we are cutting all those problems every day. And I think that is creating a momentum in entrepreneurship, and we are feeling that every day things are starting up, you know, thanks that we are like cutting tax to the real activity. So,
but there has to be, surely there's something at the top of the list. Once the election is over and you win these seats that you hope you're going to get,
yes,
in both chambers,
yes,
what do you start doing?
Well, the first, we have to approve the new national budget, that it has to reduce the fiscal deficit in 1 point. That's fundamental, because we have to show that we are achieving our commitments. No, that will be the first step. The second, we need a tax reform to reduce taxes.
So there is a tax reform bill.
Yes.
Your Treasury Minister,
yes,
Mr. Duchovny, has prepared it. What's in it? What's tax reform going to look like in Argentina?
We need to reduce income tax to those ones that reinvest the part of the profit, their profit. We need to reduce local taxes at state levels and city levels. And there are other ones that we should reduce also. But I think that will be a very good, very educating discussion for the first time, because this is the first budget, this year's budget, that we are closing with less than 3% difference from what we proposed. You have to go like decades behind to find another government that had achieved something very similar to what they proposed. No? The difference in the Kirchner period were like 20%, 30%, so there was no budget, okay?
You have taken a slow and deliberate approach to reform.
Yes.
Gradualismo.
Gradually.
Now that your policies have proved effective in many respects, mm-hmm, is it time to accelerate reform in the second half of your term? Is it time to go from gradualismo to rapidismo?
That word doesn't exist.
I'm inventing it right here for the purposes of this conversation.
Well, you're trying to match in that. Sometimes I create new words in English also. But
we can create it together.
Yes. Eric, let me tell you, I'm going as fast as possible, and in terms of history, we are going really fast. The cultural change that had happened in the last 2 years in Argentina is quite unique in the global scenario, okay? So nobody believed that we could even win the election unless that we could change so many things in such a short period. And that happened because, again, citizens understood that, as the German says, things that can come easily go away easily. We have to build what we need. We have to build the society that we dream, put in our best effort. And that's what we are doing every day.
Not faster.
As faster as we can. I think that we are going very fast. Again, not analyzing the 2 years, analyzing 100 years, okay?
It makes me think about labor reform, mm-hmm, this gradualismo. And the reason for that, of course, as you know, is that Brazil has a new labor law. It has already taken effect.
Very
and that labor law weakens unions, gives companies more flexibility to hire and fire, and allows for temporary employees in a way that doesn't exist in this country. How on earth does Argentina compete with that?
Very challenging.
For you?
For the country. Not for me.
For all
country. Of us. For all of us. So we had been talking about that with the unions. And in addition to the challenging reform, is of our partner in Mercosur. So it's double challenging, okay? Because we are already part of the same economic sector.
Are the unions willing to give up ground to make Argentina more competitive with the new Brazilian labor market?
I think that we are going to keep achieving reforms sector by sector. We have been very successful when we talked last year. We were talking about sector reforms. The first one was Vaca Muerta, this shale gas reserve that's huge, and we achieved it. Now we are having billions of dollars of investments, mainly American companies. We achieved that the same with the meat sector, the meat sector, and we are doing sector by sector the same reforms, trying to analyze what we have to commit.
But something bigger that changes the rules of the game for everybody and makes Argentina more competitive across the board.
Well, we are going to try. The good thing is that part
we
of the
try.
Obviously, but part of the cultural change is that we had rediscovered the importance of dialogue around the table, unions, government, private sector, and we are doing very good progress. Very good progress.
Mr. President, you've been kind enough to have me here every 6 months for the past year. I can hardly believe it. It's a pleasure to be back. If we have an interview 6 months from now, and I hope we do, what will we be talking about?
Of how we succeed in the new reforms, and how Argentina is improving in the growth of the economy. How are we dealing with what is going around the world, because the world is changing also very fast. But Argentina will be in a better, much better situation in 6 months than from today, because Argentina is progressing every day. Every day things are changing. Every day we are showing that the cultural change is deep and constant and permanent. No? And I feel that what we are doing is great, because we believe in what we are doing, and we had created a relation between the government and the citizens and the country and the world of confidence, as never happened before. We have to keep making grow that confidence, because Argentina history shows that we had go back and forward a couple of times. So we know that, but we really appreciate how the world had opened a huge door to Argentina, including the United States. And we expect that keep building and strengthening relations all around the world and inside Argentina, because we also need to recreate this confidence among the Argentines, no? Because now we have we are betting on creating a system that will evaluate positively those ones that fulfill the law and work, not those ones that try to cheat every day, okay?